Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Trofinet, and welcome back to Bioshock in our Let's Replay series. And there's somebody who's gonna get whacked in the face immediately. There we go. We're still playing Bioshock in our Let's Replay series, where we try to go a bit deeper into the lore. But I think we spent a lot of time discussing that already. So we're in the Little Wonders Educational Facility, which is a bit more creepy than it actually sounds. This is the area where they kept the little sisters, and they also trained them to follow the big daddies, as you'll see in a minute. I do want to find the radio first and take that down. Hello. And let's take that pheromone sample. That's one.
I can only be glad I am nowhere near you and that awful stink. Why the little ones are drawn to the smell of those pheromones is beyond anything I can understand.
So these are little girls' rooms, as you can see. So they made drawings of them being guarded by a big daddy. And there's posters around here. Always stay close to a friend. And dead bodies are angels and not creepy dead bodies, as you might assume. I do want to find that radio, just to shut it off. Can I actually... Hello? Can someone open the door for me? Did I just... Oh, there it is. There's the door control. That's also a nice touch. The door control is high up, so the little sisters can actually reach that themselves. No, you don't? Okay. Nope, get off there. There we go. Then we have more angel and... this thing, always stay close to a friend posters. And a few corpses, because this is actually where they trained their, as you can see by the syringes, where they trained the little sisters to gather Adam from corpses. Creepily enough, as I said, a really creepy area. And this is really cool. This is a bit of a psychological experiment. So they have an image of the big daddy on the left and an image of a woman on the right. If you push the button with the big daddy, you get a treat. You get potato chips. If you push the button on the right, however, you get a shock, which is to condition the little sisters to go always for the big daddies and not towards women, towards their mothers, as you might think. And there we go. All good girls gather. Look at that. They gather blood from the sleeping angels, or corpses, as we know they are. I do want to go through these areas a bit with structures. So this one is blocked off as well. We can also hear another big daddy trying to get a little sister in vain, because we rescued all the little sisters already in this area. Oh, room with a camera. Autopsy. Why do you need an autopsy chamber in an area where you gather little girls? That is just creepy. But, I think you can already assume why that is. The tables are actually too small for grown people. So they put little sisters in here. And this is actually where they farmed the Adam slugs that were in there, in their bodies, after they were done gathering Adam. So they killed the little sisters on these tables, sadly enough. And creepily enough, because that's just horrible. But we have another tonic over there and another pheromone sample. So let's gather around here a bit. Two more autopsy tables. God damn it, this is so harsh. This is so harsh. But hey, the tonic, safe cracker. Oh, we have another. Yeah, there we go.
I don't wanna go on the table.
And this just breaks your heart, doesn't it? So that was a little sister. We have a lot of little sister dresses over here. And this is... this is the freezer. This is the freezer where they put, yeah, temporary waste storage. They put the corpses of the little sisters over there. And that was the memory of a dead little sister begging Su Chong not to take her to the table, the autopsy table, confirming that, yes, they killed the little sisters on those tables. There we go. Don't need to reload, because, yeah, we don't need to reload. Pheromones sample. There we go. 2 out of 3. Is Tenenbaum gonna say anything about that? No. Safecracker 2. Don't really need that. Are your enemies trying to lock away what's rightfully yours? Don't let them keep your hard-earned goods, and get them back with new Safecracker 2. Hacksmart wants you to get what's coming to you. Oh, let's leave that over there. Don't really need that. Let's store that in the gene bank. Can we actually open any of these freezers? No, we can't. So no audio diary here to confirm what I just told you, but that memory should be evidence enough. Yeah, this is a bit of a harsh area. Anything in here that I could use? I might as well just hack it right by it out and buy these automatic hack tools with all the money in the world. There we go, all our money gone. Just like that. We have a lot more rooms in here. I'm gonna try and open these one by one because there are a few interesting ones if I'm not mistaken. So this one has chips underneath the bed. They started to hide themselves underneath the bed to not have to go to the table, of course. And yeah, a bit more drawings of a dead dog, for example, or a dead horse. I don't know what that's supposed to be. Angel. And it seems like this little sister actually started realizing what the angels actually are. And we have room number 3. Another syringe, and this one was a bit too enthusiastic in her job, so she, syringed the fuck out of this guy. There's something behind, yeah, more dollars. You kinda can use them right now. Let's keep the electrobolt. Okay. You're supposed to open if I zap you. No? Okay then, never mind, so this one is open. A teddy bear with a big... Ooh, look at that. A teddy bear that has blocks on his eyes, indicating that it's supposed to be dead. And of course another syringe. And is that... Yeah, director's commentary. Let's not play that, because this is a really, really creepy area for some reason. Is there something underneath the bed? Nope, nothing underneath the bed. So this is an area we couldn't drop into, sadly. So there's two we didn't enter yet, but we also have an area down here. Whack this thing, thank you. What was that? Or something? Cream filled cake, don't really need that. And nothing in the cabinet. So let's head down here. Oh. Is it completely blocked off? No. Okay. Well, I think if I just stand here, it's gonna fire at me then. Ow! Don't hit me! It's the turret behind you that's firing at you, not me. Kinda took a lot of health off me there. Oh yeah, this is a room, the security room where the turrets fire at you if you're in that security room. Funny. But we came from the other direction right now, so that wasn't an issue. We came from upstairs and not downstairs. So let's head back up. Let's see if we can't drop down on the ones we couldn't actually enter from down below. So that's... Yeah, we can actually enter in this one.
Now this is a big daddy. Are you ready? Now go to the little sister vent by the proving grounds.
We will, but give us a minute.
I've got Rapture now. I've got the Atom now. You think that tin suit's even half enough to put the spear in me?
This is also a very, very creepy room, by the way. A teddy bear and a tombstone with mommy and daddy, indicating that probably Ryan killed its parents, her parents. So the last one we couldn't enter was the one over here, I believe. Yeah, this one. So if we go up and then to the left, so the first one we should encounter, another pheromone sample. We're gonna keep finding these. Oh, this guy is clearly not... That's the first time I saw a splicer do that. He lifted his head up. Yeah, you're dead. Now you're really dead. Why just girls?
I know why it has to be children, but why just girls? This I cannot determine why, but I know it is so. Fontaine says, one less bathroom to build in the orphanage. It is amazing to watch the effect of Atom on their small bodies. Their own cells replaced by the new stems the instant they are damaged. These children are practically invulnerable. It is a shame you could not do the same thing to an adult. There would be quite a market for a man you could not kill.
So it needs to be young children because of their, well, their age. One, because they're so young and their styles can be easily manipulated. More easily than an adult. And the reason why it's girls, not men, is actually explained in Bioshock 2. So I'm not gonna spoil that just yet. It's also not that important to the story in this game. But it is a bit more important in the sequel. And this is also very interesting. So there's... underneath the blankets is actually a leather strap used to restrain the little sisters if they're, well, too much of a nuisance. So let's open that up again. I'm just gonna quickly check upstairs to see if there's anything we missed at the end of the room here. Hi. Did you seriously not hear me coming? I'm stomping on the ground. I know I have the wrench lurker mod equipped, the tonic equipped, but that shouldn't be an excuse. So, hidey hole. So yeah, there's another indication what they should do. Another indoctrination method. And I think that is pretty much it. I don't think there's anything else we need to check out. Yeah, that's probably it. So let's head back up and out this way. Can we... is there something in here? Nah. We don't really need that. I might as well take a quick hop to a U-in vent. If I can find one. I think there's one in... Failsafe Armored Escort, so give me a minute. So there we go. We can make a few more thingies with everything we've got. So let's fill that up. Yeah. Yeah. That's pretty much it, I think. Holy shit. Yeah, this is the same UN vent where I spilled all that stuff around. So that's that. Okay. So let's head back to the center area. And, yeah. Let's finish this. So, we're back where the door is.
You need to bring them out of hiding and then they'll let you in the door. Go on, hit the vent with your wrench.
The only area I didn't check was this area down below here, so I'm quickly gonna check this out as well. Just check if I don't have any audio diaries I missed around here. So this leads into the little wonders, and that's... this is the area where we can get shot at by the turrets over there. We just get locked in. So that's nothing that we actually missed, so never mind. So, let's lure out a little sister now, shall we? And we actually need to do that.
What you wait for? Go on! Hit the vent with your wrench!
Just as the big daddies do. But instead of banging it with our fists, we're gonna do that with our wrench. There we go. And right now, we need to be extremely careful. Because now this little sister is under our
would
protection.
Mean very much to me if you will be gentle with the girls. Mein kleines Mädchen.
Mein kleines Mädchen. My little girls, literally, in Dutch. In German, German, German. Dutch is my language. It's German. So, now we have to protect her. And protect her we shall. Not a single splicer will lay a finger on her. She is mine. Okay, so let's go to the Proving Grounds. So there we go, the Proving Grounds, Museum Lobby.
The little ones will lead you to Fontaine, but you must protect them.
And we will protect them, Tenenbaum. We have everything we need right here. I think we have electric gel equipped as well. Yeah, there we go. So the Proving Grounds is the Museum of Rapture. And it's, in fact, the final gauntlet we need to perform to take care of Fontaine.
It's been a long road. You don't even remember most of it. Put you on a sub when you were just a sprout.
Yes, you did, but that doesn't give you, a reason to attack us. So we have pretty much one of each vending machine right here. So I might as well take a look while we still can. And build a few more thingies, just because we can. I think there's one more after this. But, we're gonna save our stuff for when we get to the last area. Quickly gonna check around. I do need to be careful, because I don't wanna... have the little sister get damaged. Oh, is there a camera around here? Yeah, okay. Yeah, hurry, Mr. B. I know, but I think there's something around here. Just want to quickly check, because it's the only chance we're going to get. Is there no audio diary here? I thought there was one. Yeah, time to go indeed. Okay then, never mind. Let's follow her. Yeah, you want to see the angels. That's a bit weird. So she's a saved little sister. So that's making it kind of weird that she still wants to perform her duties. No. So they're firing at the Big Daddy down there. I don't know if you can actually see it. Yeah. She's firing up, dropping the skeleton right on top of the Big Daddy. Don't be a slut. So just another scene indicating that Rapture is really, really going to hell. Okay, so let's follow her. We don't want to get her damaged.
Hurry, Mr. B.
I really wound you up with that wife and child bit.
Oh, me poor Moira. I me wee baby Patrick.
Maybe one day I'll get me a real family. They play
hurry,
well with
hurry, Mr. Bubbles.
So there we go. The wife and child business was also completely fake. Which is, well, just terrible. Terrible of him. Really, really terrible. Hey, hi. You shall not take my little sister. I think I might be able to hack this thing. Yeah, there we go. That might be able to help us defend the little sister. I hear another spider splicer, but I'm not seeing him. Test subject 1. And this is the annoying part in this area. They're gonna try and attack her.
Oh, Mr. B.
Even though they are physically free of the room together, still showing mental conditioning still holds steps with their terrible past. For sins such as this, you can never atone.
So now we're gonna get ambushed, because the splicers are riled by the gathering of the little sister. So we just need to defend her, so that's why I put up a bit of a defensive perimeter until she's ready. Really performing the task of a Big Daddy, right? So the anti-personnel round should do wonders in here. Just gonna switch back to a few weapons. There we go, straight in the face. That was actually nice. I just put these up just in case one of them tried to go through the back. The little sister is starting to sound a bit creepy. Yeah, okay, so she's done with this one. And now we're gonna move on. Just gonna use the shotgun if we can get them closer and gather everything we can from these corpses, because we might be able to use that just yet. There's another first aid kit. You have to keep a lookout that she doesn't get ambushed by any of the... Yeah, there we go. No. Stop it! Fire at me! Not at her! Fire at me! I think he had a... Oh, okay. I'm just gonna quickly move along here. And let's buy this one out and then just quickly hack this one. Yeah, okay, so that's a flamer. Yeah, okay, that's a flamer. So that's more defenses for us. I'm gonna hack this thing as well. There we go. And there's the next subject. So... we have a nice trap over there. There we go. Just gonna put down a few. So there we go. And let's Let's just keep an eye out. Yeah, there we go. They're going through the back. Just gonna let the fire damage take care of that and the bolts. They're coming from over there. They're gonna explode. Hopefully that doesn't damage the little sister over there. Because that might be... I can't take that back. So. Yeah, there they go. They exploded. No damage. Nope. There we go. The flamer taking care of everything. Might as well reload this. Yeah, okay, she's done already. Never mind. She's done. She's running. Why are you running? Stop running. Stop running. Stop running. Oh, shit. That might be a problem. No, I'm not going to hurt him. Okay, so this is... I don't know if this is actually the last door or it's not... Where are you going? Yeah, I'm hurrying. Dancing in the sky. Yes, indeed. Okay. I think we went through that pretty quickly, actually. Uh-oh. Hi. Hi there. So there's another bouncer up there. A bit mad that we stole one of his little sisters and he's leaving. Wait a second. I'm going to just... check back here, because I'm wondering if there are no audio diaries in this area. I'm still doubting that a bit. Didn't check behind this place, but... I don't think there is, actually. Weirdly enough. She's not getting damaged, so I think she's pretty safe. Yeah, I'm a slowpoke. I know. I know. I'm sorry. I really am. Okay. So we're now downstairs where that... Oh, shit. Where that skeleton dropped down on the... Oh, shit. Shit, 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 shit. Where is she? Aww. Aww. That was... That was mean. That was mean.
Hurry, Mr. Bubbles.
She's almost dead. God damn it. That was not nice. Oh, that was too bad. I just got her in time, but that was nasty. So she started running and there was a turret hiding out there while I was dealing with this one. Oh, that was nasty. Kind of completely forgot about that one. Open the door. It looks like there's a camera on the other side. You need to be careful. Let's hack this thing. Well, let's use an auto hack on it. No, no, no. No, no, no. Don't walk. No, 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 no. Oh, don't. Oh, ho, 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 ho. I thought she was going to die because of my shocking, but I think she's pretty much immune to what I'm doing. Stop running. Stop running, please. No, 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 no. Ah.
They are not longer in use with Adam. They are as vulnerable as any child.
So there we go.
If a little one falls, you can call for another at the vent.
Sadly, she died. Yeah, it's too bad we couldn't save her. That one turret fucked me over. That was too bad. So now we can actually get another one, but that's sad, actually. That's really sad. Just because she ran off like that, I couldn't protect her anymore. Because I'm really slow in water. Okay. There we go. Another little sister. Protect her. Yes, indeed. We will. I won't let this one die. She actually has a different dress than the previous one. And I think they just spawned another splicer just to mess with me. So she's behind me, so that's good. She should be behind me, not in front of me. But I heard another splicer. I don't see any test subject, by the way, so I don't think we have another one yet. Oh, never mind. There we have one. I think there's another camera. Let's auto hack this one as well. Let's check out the defenses a bit. swap to proximity mines again and put one. What? Where was it? Where is she? There we go. Where is my little sister? Where did she go?
No time to waste.
Where is she? Hello? Oh, there she is. She was behind a bit. She lagged behind. Come on. Oh my god, she's almost drowning in that water. Okay, okay, okay. I'm gonna put a few proximity mines up. So let's put one here. And then here on the corner. Yeah, I know she's gonna walk through that, but she doesn't trigger it. I hope. I really hope. So let's use the trap bolts. Put down a few.
Hurry! The harvesting will draw the attention of the swipers.
So there we go, that's one. So one of the turrets just went through the trap bolt again. I am not gonna let a single splicer get through here. Are you gone? Oh, you're done. Okay, never mind. You're done. Apparently you're done.
Hurry, Mr. Bubbles.
Hurry. Yes, I am hurrying. I want to have you die again. Oh shit.
Hurry, Mr. B.
I'm looking down her skirt. I'm sorry for that. So let's gather all that. I don't think we have anything else here. The camera even exploded for some reason. Destroyed camera. And I think we should be getting ready for another fight. Because I think if we go around the corner... Yep, there he is! Oh, that's too bad. Yeah, that bouncer is not gonna survive. I think I'm just shy of a few points to fully research bouncers, by the way, which is actually really sad. So that means I'm not gonna get the trophy for researching pretty much everything.
Better for the girl to be with you. Better with you than alone. Alone in the crawling darkness.
You do realize you sent those to me, because those are healed little sisters, so they're yours, not... Yeah, never mind. Always found that a bit strange. So there's more here. Eve Hypo, definitely can use that, apparently. More proximity mines. And there's another grenade launcher here as well, just loaded with frag grenades. But not much else. I don't know how he got in here. Probably collapsed pretty much everything trying to get to me. But hey, yeah, yeah, hop, hop, Mr. B. So did she open the door for me already? Oh, apparently she did, but there's fire outside.
That might be plenty for the work of scrubs and a pencil pushes, but I need more. More! I want a splice! There ain't nothing left to splice with!
And for some reason, another dead cat!
Yeah. You must use the needle of the little sister to drain Fontaine of his Adam. It is the only way to defeat him.
Okay. So as we could hear over the radio, Fontaine has spliced up immensely. He has all the Adam in the world and has boosted his body with everything imaginable.
Fontaine is nearby. You are reaching close now.
And we need to use the little sister's syringe to drain the Adam from him, just as they do. So we have every vending machine available here. So we're just gonna quickly check everything out. Let's check this out. There's a lot of frag grenades around here. Clearly loading us up for whatever is ahead. And as the little sister already says, we need to accept her syringe. Here we go. And stick it in the bad man. Adam harvesting tool.
Fontaine waits above. There will be no going back from here. Make sure you are ready to face him before moving on.
We are ready. We are completely ready. I'm just going to check out the UN vent here. And there's an... Oh, director's commentary. Thank you. There we go. Hack this thing. Oh, well, auto hack. I mean, come on. And then we have electric gel. Fill that up again. Don't think we can maybe buy one automatic hack tool. Fill up on exploding bugs and anti-personnel rounds. Trap bolts, we've been using those. Yeah, just buy everything. I'm just gonna fill up everything because, yeah, there we go. I just wanted that trophy. There we go. Sploosh! Explosion! Stuff explosion. Let's check this out. Just. Yeah, you know what? Just the Eve Hyper to fill us up. Let's check out that we have everything properly equipped here. Anti-personnel rounds. Do I use electric gel or liquid nitrogen? Might actually be handy in this case. If we can use it to freeze a few of the splicers we're gonna meet. And switch this to heat-seeking RPGs. There we go. And that's about it. Maybe I'm gonna go for the incendiary bolt just for the damage. And then let's check out the Adam Bandido. Yeah, we're gonna hack that as well. And then let's fill up on anti-person. Okay, never mind. That's all there is. Yeah, that's it. That's it. So we're completely ready. It's gonna be a bit of a longer episode. But we're gonna finish this. We're gonna finish this today. So let's head up the elevator. We are a big daddy right now. And we're gonna face Fontaine. Here we go. Going up. Going up towards Frank Fontaine.
I remember when me and the crowd put you in that sub. You were no more than two. You were my ace in the hole. But you were also the closest thing I ever had to a son. And that's why this hurts. Betrayal, kid. Life ain't strictly business.
I think you betrayed us. And not the other way around, so we get a little loading screen for some reason. Everything looked loaded, but hey. That over there is Fontaine. Hello, sir. So now we need to drain him from the atom he has. There we go. Stick it in there. Now we need to do that four times, clearly. And every time he's gonna change forms. So the best strategy is to keep your distance and just circle around them a bit. Doesn't really do much, apparently. Since he's fired up, he's actually really handy to hit with the heat-seeking rockets. There we go. Let's just fire away. And now, when he's damaged enough, he goes towards the thing here, and then let's drain him again. And then he's gonna change forms. So now he's electrified. Electricity will do nothing at the moment. So I'm gonna first use... Gonna run around a bit, because there's a lot of explosives around as well. So I'm gonna use these. Yeah, we're gonna get him. Oh yeah, it's frost, right. Okay, that means I can actually use the electric shell. Reload, bitch! For fuck's sake. Oh no, that's the frost. That's the frost, that's bad. It's kind of bugging out from that, apparently. And down.
I paid good money for you.
Fuck you! Yes, that's what you get! And so now he's shocked. Let's go with the incendiary bolts. I'm gonna have to be careful here because there's more splices around as well. Oh shit! You need to be careful. So let's use Insect Swarm and annoy him a bit because he's really, really. There you go.
I'm ready for you.
Are you ready for me? Doesn't look like you are. Oh, don't. I'm just gonna keep my distance again, because that seemed to work better. There we go. And that's the last one, and that should finish him off. And then we get smacked in the face.
I had you built! I sent you topside! I called you back, showed you what you was, what you was capable of! Even that life you thought you had, that was something I dreamed up, and I tattooed inside your head! Now if you don't call that family, I don't know what is!
And the trophy's spoiling it a bit, but there's the little sisters are gonna help us out. Draining him completely. And then, yeah, that's kind of gruesome, but there we go. Kill them. You killed them, alright. You did, yeah. Yep, we get it. And that's it. There we have the good ending.
They offered you this city. And you refused it.
So that's the genetic key.
And what did you do instead? What I've come to expect of you. You saved them. You gave them the one thing that was stolen from them. A chance. A chance to learn. To find love. To live. And in the end, what was your reward? You never said. But I think I know. A family.
And that's it. Goddammit, that still gives me tears in my eyes. So yeah, as you can see, we got the good ending because we rescued all the little sisters. We rescued the little sisters in a hole. We set them free, let them outside, let them live their own lives, and in the end, they still kept beside us. Because as you can see, we actually grew a lot faster old. We grew old a lot faster because, we were genetically modified to age at a rapid pace. So when the little sisters grew to be women, young women, we already were at a very old age and died, but died very happily with a new family by our sides, even though Fontaine told us we would never find anything else. So, that was it. That was Bioshock. I think that was my 7th playthrough of Bioshock for some reason. Hope you guys enjoyed it. It's not over yet, of course, because we're gonna go straight into Bioshock 2. So I'll see you guys in a few days then, when we start off Bioshock 2. The sequel that a lot of people thought was inferior to this one. It is in a story sense. It's a bit. It still has a very good story. Not that it has a bad story, but it still has a very good story. but it was, regarding to this one, looking at this one, it was a bit worse than this one, but that doesn't say much, of course, since this game story was impeccable. The gameplay is also a lot better, as you will see in the next episode, because we can actually combine plasmids and weapons in Bioshock 2, but that will be for next episode. So, if you enjoyed the episode and enjoyed the series as a whole, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube, and especially if you did enjoy the series, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And with that said, thank you guys again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you guys in Bioshock 2. Goodbye! Yeah,